We try to put the patients first at all times. And that's a fundamental philosophy to St. John, that is that we are here to serve our patients.
The vision and mission of St. John is to provide a service of excellence to all, irrespective of their beliefs, ethnicity, ability to pay.
I know that St. John, or the people in the community, had a great faith at St. John and its services. So I think we are well accepted in the community, and the people does trust us.
Most of the nurses and the doctors spend all their career time and life at the hospital. We have nurses who spend 30, 40 years of their life here.
You get bombarded every day with news and other stuff that's happening all over, but you see in the middle of that, it's almost like an oasis.
Bear in mind that about 75% of the eye problems that we see in this part of the world are preventable, and also about 75% of them are treatable. And yet, without us doing what we are doing, a lot of those would not be treated. That's a real tragedy. I had a previous career that was in the army. And quite a lot of that was spent in refugee camps, places like Rwanda, also involved with displaced people in Bosnia. Generally had quite a humanitarian angle to the work that I was doing within the army. But I left the army, I was looking to join something that would give me similar satisfaction, something bigger than myself, something that I could really embrace as a future career, rather than just another job. There's a long history, St. John. It really goes back nearly 1,000 years when there was a hospital in Jerusalem, which was attached to the Church of St. John, and that's where we took our name from. In 1882, we set up an eye hospital in Jerusalem, and that was at the wish of Queen Victoria, and she was quite astute about this because eye problems were a huge deal in this part of the world. Even today, the number of eye problems is at least 10 times what you'd expect to find in Western Europe. We're treating about 124,000 people a year, and that's all across Jerusalem, the West Bank and Gaza, and we have mobile outreach units that go to the back and beyond. So we take what we have, the best of what we have to offer, to the most remote areas.
St. John is not only about eyes. St. John is very much part of the community. I think every single family in this part of the world has been touched either directly or indirectly by the hospital.
Of a large of difficulties in Gaza, especially we have witness of three wars. We've seen a lot of injured people with eye trauma. This 10 years was very difficult for Gaza people because of economical blockade of Gaza. That's why unemployment rate was increased. Now it's about 40%. Thank God we was able to help these people by offering him services free of charge and sometimes with large of discounts.
Gaza, we put a clinic in there a few years ago and in a very run-down part of the old city. And it's, in a sense, it's been a victim of its own success. Obviously, we started with small numbers. Now we're looking at about 26,000 people per year.
I have very long history of St. John. When I was 5 years, I got eye trauma in my left eye. I was treated in Jerusalem by a specialist there. And at that time, I have decided to be eye doctor.
عملية مي بيضاء؟ عملية في 5/11. شفت العمليه الحمد لله 100% الف الف يعني
الاوبريشن واز فيري جود
وبس تعلقت فيها قعدت يرجعوني مراجعات لما طابت خارج قالوا مع السلامه والفضل لله والحاج سان جون هو القوي في غزه.
ثانك يو جاد ثانك يو
سان جون هو القوي يعني قام بالخدمات الواجبه بقوم للطفل الصغير حتى الكفل الاختيار 77 سنه يخدم له ما يتكبر على صغير ولا كبير.
Do we have now good projects that we are building a new hospital? We will establish all kind of service.
It is also the only major building being put up in Gaza at the moment by any NGO. Now, that doesn't just happen. That's taken a lot of diplomacy and working on things and a lot of effort by a lot of people. We will be able to keep going in any future conflict. We had to close for a brief period during the last conflict because we were putting our patients in danger with the very rundown premises that we had. If there'd been any shelling nearby, they would be in very much at risk. The new premises, we've adapted to that. And that's part and parcel of, again, providing the best service and continuity of service, no matter what.
I'm Dr. Jean Garth. I'm the medical director of St. John Eye Hospital. I've been here since 2001.
Yamin.
When I first came here, there were many expatriate doctors. There were very few Palestinians who were trained to be specialists. St. John Eye Hospital decided that it was necessary to train the local doctors, Palestinian doctors, at some point to give them a chance to become ophthalmologists.
I think this decision was the right decision because in the past, whenever we had a war or problems to do with intifadas, nurses felt unsafe here, and experienced nurses unfortunately had to leave, sometimes by orders of their governments and embassies, and we were left high and dry, if you like.
You are tapping into the people's resources, the community, because in a way you don't want to appear to be giving handouts. You want the people themselves to be involved.
Now we have reached a point of self-sufficiency. I'm proud to say I am the first Palestinian to become the nursing director at the St. John Eye Hospital.
The School of Nursing is, I always say, it's the backbone of the hospital. I should say I'm proud of this because, you know, nurses, mostly among all other teams who stay along with the patients, providing the care, follow up the care.
You take time to cope at first because it's a strange environment for us. It's a new specialty. We need to learn many new things. But at the end, we are all one big family.
St. John is one of those organizations that bridges gaps and does what it does in spite of the situation.
Since the Second Intifada, so going back about nearly 15 years ago, there has been very little contact between the Jewish communities and the Palestinian communities, and that's a tragedy. And of course, in the long term, this is going to lead to a world of pain, I'm afraid, for both sides. We're one of the very, very few areas where there is some crossover, at a professional level and also with dealing with our patients.
Our relationship with Hadassah University Hospital, an Israeli hospital, goes back many years, but it got reinforced in 2001. There were these joint efforts between Israel and Palestine in areas of education to enhance peace. And out of the 14 projects that they sponsored, the one that was most successful was ours with Hadassah and training doctors.
Generally, our department wants to help the development of ophthalmology for the Palestinians as well as for the Israelis. And we do it by training, by teaching. And recently, also, we try to help in developing research in ophthalmology in St. John.
I was in the jail for 6 months in the First Intifada, where I was an activist in Gaza. In my training in Hadassah, I have to examine Israeli soldiers who were participating in a war in Gaza or were shooting in the West Bank, or Israeli victims. And also I had to treat or examine prisoners, Palestinians.
It's our medical commitment. And we can have all kind of political views, and still we have to treat everybody. As soon as you enter the gates of Adassa, no politics, only medicine.
Mobile outreach has been going on for decades, actually, in one form or another. And it's always been a problem with communities being isolated. And also, again, although the distances are not vast in Palestine and Israel, it's the barriers that you have to get around. That wall that is up there is a really great big solid barrier. I think it's about 560 miles in length, it's something of that order. It's vast. We've got a great team. They're a really good team. We've chosen them quite carefully, and they're led by a very capable individual, Khaled, who is an absolute star when it comes to managing this day in, day out.
It was my dream since I was a kid, because I used to come with some relative to have a treatment in St. John. And I was thinking myself, if one day I might be a member of this hospital. I kept the hard work, and I always try to upgrade myself. I have the ambition to be involved in St. John and in the community. Mobile outreach gave me the opportunity to achieve those dreams.
One of the things they do extraordinarily well is liaise with the local community leaders. They plan ahead so that when they go to a particular area, now it might be a Bedouin encampment, or more likely it's going to be an isolated village. That village, the word has been put around, the people have gathered in from the surrounding area.
So we give them a notice like 1 month before that we are in that specific day, we are attending to health mobile outreach clinic. And in this, they calling the patients and they put announcement in the media that we are there. Last year, our number has been close to 12,000 people. And always this number is increasing because the demand is increasing.
This is Ahmed, 12 years old, from Akraba village, near Nablus. He is suffering from recurrent bilateral vernal keratoconjunctivitis, which is an allergic disorder. And we see it often in our country because the humidity and the hot weather and climate, it's important to treat it at this age while they are kids, because it can lead to visual loss and permanent blindness sometimes.
That's it. Actually, the eyes is the window to the body, and the eyes is part of the body that any disease affecting the body can affect the eye. There is multiple systemic diseases that affect the eye, such as diabetes, such as hypertension, arthritis, hematological disorder, endocrine, metabolic diseases, even syndromes and genes.
We are giving health education session, which contribute in the elevation of health awareness amongst the community, which gives, you know, high level standards of health.
Here is one of our outreach clinic patients, Ferian, and she's 58 years old, and she got diabetes since 17 years. She didn't check her eyes for a long time. Well, upon the examination, she has a bilateral cataract, which is the opacity of the lens, that the diabetes speed up the formation of the cataract. And she has a diabetic retinopathy, one of the most common disease, most common diabetic eye disease. The diabetic retinopathy is severe, and she needs an urgent referral to the hospital
at St. John to help her to regain some vision and stop the disease from being affecting her vision and causing blindness.
Clearly, the more severe operations and those related to trauma, as from the recent conflict, and the very complicated cases, those have to be referred down to Jerusalem. The best care that can be provided anywhere in the world, despite the challenging circumstances. So we are recognized worldwide for the quality of work that we produce and the equipment that we have and the way that we conduct our business.
We're trying to enlarge the bubble mechanically to make our life easier. This is the FECO machine. It works on ultrasound waves that it will divide the lens matters, and as well there is vacuum in it, we will suck it, okay?
Segment removal.
See, there is suction and there is dividing also. This is the artificial lens. Yes, give the next patient.
Local.
It's it. And centered, excellent. Salamte.
Next ready.
On all fronts, we're always trying to develop what we have. We're trying to improve. We're trying to upgrade the service that we provide. All the time, we're aiming to do the best that we can, and we've got one eye on the future at all times. The place in Jerusalem where the Order of St. John began, right the way back 900 years ago, is still owned by the Order of St. John. Now, what I want to do is that very, very old building, which traces its roots back to 700 AD, when it was an Islamic hospital, I would like to turn that back into a walk-in clinic. It means a lot of the people, stallholders and people like that working in the old city of Jerusalem, will be able to go in. If it's difficult or complicated, we can then refer them to the hospital. If it's simple, we'll treat them there and then. And along those lines, we're building a brand new clinic in Hebron with new operating theatre there. We're going to upgrade the clinic that we have in the northern part of the West Bank in a small town called Annapta. It's a small town, but it draws patients in from all the surrounding big areas like Nablus and Jenin. We have to sustain that, and that requires quite a lot of funding, is important, is our lifeblood, and we constantly have to chase that.
At the start of the year, we have a fundraising target, which is usually quite a high target of about £5 million.
With St. John, you consistently have to fundraise every single year or patients don't get seen.
Patients who come to us, many of them are unable to afford the drops, the surgeries, even the subsidized prices we give to these patients.
I believe that the people who help us, they make an immediate change in other people's lives and for a long term.
And the help needs a lot of money because it needs trained doctors and nurses. It needs developing that work. The need gets greater, not smaller.
Without the funding that we get from individual donors and institutions and other branches of St. John, we would be struggling.
You know, the first time I went out there, I came back crying, knowing that I wanted to do something, knowing that I wanted to raise more money. So you're motivated. You're not motivated by your target. You're motivated by the people that you see and the things that you've seen.
I was deeply moved a couple of months ago when my wife and I, we were in Jerusalem. We went to visit the eye hospital, and I saw with great delight how the personnel, doctors, nurses, and the administration behaved with impeccable dignity, and how each patient was dealt with the delicatesse that you would like to have personally yourself if you were a patient in any hospital anywhere in the world.
Jerusalem is a place that benefits from any surgeon that wants to go out there, and we all feel inspired to do that.
We're not talking about politics here. We're talking about human life. We're talking about survival and the ability to see. And in those circumstances, the cooperation that St. John's has managed to achieve with the Israeli authorities and with the Palestinian authorities in Ramallah is remarkable.
And we're very proud not only of our Christian background, but of the first aid and other support that we provide to people all around the world. We are a great global order. Sight saved makes all the difference in the modern world, which means that people can be economically active and not dependent. And in the modern world, those are the things that make all the difference. You go right the way back to the 11th century. Those people that set up the Order of St. John that time did it for the right reasons. They established early on that we are here to serve.
Good evening. Thank you very, very much for asking me to be here with you this evening, Your Royal Highnesses, my lords, ladies and gentlemen. Now, eye care is extraordinary in what it can do these days, but it does require the most advanced machinery and it requires training. And as far as I'm concerned, I want the last years of my life to be spent doing this work, joining all of you who've spent the last 38, 40 years giving your help and the much needed money tonight. I thank you for giving all you can and being here for the eyes of St. John.
Thank you.